Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I am going to be doing the long-awaited video that you all have been requesting for quite some time now, and that is a what's on my phone video. What? So I got a new phone back in December because for those of you who do not know, I desperately needed one, like so bad. It was just, my old phone was just such a piece of crap. So I got a new phone and you guys really wanted to see a what's on my phone video. So that is what I'm going to be doing today. If you would like to see my old one, I will go ahead and throw that down in the description box. But first I just want to get out of the way. The phone that I have is not a high end popular phone. It is just a very standard, simple smartphone. I have the Kyocera Hydro Icon. So it's nothing special. It's just a cool little waterproof little cell phone. I'm gonna be showing you all of my current phone cases that I have for it, and I'm gonna be taking you inside the phone and showing you all of the stuff that I have in here and how I keep it organized. If you would like to see what is on my phone, let's go ahead and get started, and be sure to thumbs up and share this video if you guys did enjoy. So let's do this. Okay, so here is my phone. Here is basically what it looks like when it lays down. As you can see, it just says Kyocera at the top. Before we get out of the way, this nail color that you are seeing is one by Madam Glam, and it is in the color So Nude. In case any of you are wondering, that is what I'm wearing on my nails because I know I'm gonna get tons of questions on that. So yeah, basically here is my phone and what it looks like. It is just an all black phone. And as you can see, I have a lot of trouble with these stupid fucking screen protectors. Oh, I hate them so much. The top looks beautiful, and then right when I get down to this area is when all goes to hell. So yeah, basically as you can see, I do struggle a lot with screen protectors. So if any of you have any solution on how to get these stupid bubbles out, please let me know in a comment. But yeah, so there is what my phone looks like. It's about a 4-inch screen, and then four this way and then two that way. So it's a pretty medium, small, just standard smartphone. Like I said, it's not an iPhone or it's not a Samsung Galaxy, whatever is on the market today. But before we get into the phone, I wanna show you guys what my phone cases look like. So the case that I currently have on my phone is this guy right here. I bought him at the phone store where I bought my phone, but I know you can get this exact same one on Amazon. If you just search it, it should come up. That's at least where I found it. I will try to provide links to all of these phone cases that I'm going to show you down in the description box. But yeah, here is what this phone case looks like. It's really, really cute. It kind of has like this sailor looking look to it. I wore this case on my phone when I was in Florida because you can't go to Florida without a cute case like this. Am I right? Right. On the front, it has a front piece as well. And yeah, so that is what that phone case looks like. Moving on to my next phone case, it is this one right here. Again, I have the Kyocera Hydro Icon, and this case right here is just a plastic type feel. Another thing is this case is like a soft matte kind of feeling, so it's very, very soft, and it just looks like this. I used to own this exact same phone case on a different phone way back in the day, so it's kind of like nostalgic to have this case. I really like it. It's just white, black with some really pretty pink flowers, and it is also a two-part case, so it has the little front and then it has the back as well. So here is my newest one that I have acquired. It is a silicone type feeling, so it's super, super bendy. It is just one piece. It just looks like that, and it is a Galaxy. Galaxy is very, very pretty in my opinion. I really like the look of it. I even have it as my phone wallpaper right now, which you guys will see in a second. But yeah, this one is just a Galaxy type phone case, and again, it's really flexible. It fits on the phone really good. The only complaint I have about this phone case is the little on button. It makes it really hard to turn my phone on because it's covered by this like really thick kind of silicone button, and same with like the volume right here. But yeah, other than that, I think this case is absolutely gorgeous. Again, bought off Amazon for really, really cheap, affordable prices. And then the very last phone case that I have for my phone is this one right here. And this one was not bought off any site. It wasn't bought off Amazon or anything like that. This is actually a phone case that my younger sister made me for Christmas. It's just, I think she gets all of these little designs off of Etsy, I'm pretty sure. And then the type of glue that she uses is the Loctite. I'm not sure, I'll put that information in the description box for you guys, but she did make this for me, so I didn't buy it off of a site or anything. Again, it does have a front and a back. The front just kind of has these little jewels here, and then the back is all blinged out like this. This is probably my all-time favorite phone case. I only have four of them, and out of all four, this is my absolute favorite. It's really, really pretty. It's got like the matte cosmetics, the Barbie, hence my YouTube name, ha ha ha. We have Louis Vuitton over here. We have the MAC, the nail polish, and just all of the really pretty kind of gems and jewels. And I've had it for a few months now and it hasn't broken off. So it just goes to show how talented and how amazing my sister is. So Brooke, if you're watching this video, I absolutely love it. And again, thank you so, so much. Okay, so here are my phone cases all laid out. I only have four of them, but I just recently got my phone, so I'm still kind of building up my collection, but all three of these were from Amazon, and then this one was homemade. Okay, so again, here's what the front of my phone looks like. You just have the home, the menu, and the back key over here, and then on the side, you have the volume up and down key. Here you have the headphone jack, and then you have the power button, and just nothing on this side. On the back, you have the camera, the flash or flashlight, and then the speaker. So here's what my phone looks like when you turn it on the home screen. Here I just have my phone, I have my contacts, I have my text messaging, and then I have Google Chrome. And as you can see, my wallpaper is just a really cool galaxy type wallpaper. Sorry if you can see the camera in the reflection, I'm sorry about that. Up here we have the Google search bar, we have the time, the battery life, Wi-Fi, alarm, and then the phone volume. Then here we just have the camera. My number one complaint about this phone is the actual camera because it's not very good. It is, I believe it's 8 megapixels, but the camera just sucks on this phone. So if you're someone who likes to take selfies or anything like that, I don't recommend this phone because the camera and video camera are not very good on it. I'll just zoom you in a little bit more. So here I have the camera, and then down here I have my flashlight app where you can just turn on, where I just turn it on and you have the flashlight right here. And this little home menu right here are things that I most commonly use. So when you open it up, we have Facebook Messenger, I have Instagram, I have Twitter, and then I have YouTube and my Gmail. So it just looks like that. Leave a comment if you see yourself. Woo! You're in my video. My YouTube, where I can see all of my subscriptions, people who I watch on YouTube. So we have Pink Sparkles. Yay, she uploaded a video. April and Justin, Jaclyn Hill, Brittany Balin, Shan XO, Avril Lavigne, duh. Yeah, that is basically everything that I have on my little home screen here. If you go over this way, we have more of my little organized looking little area right here. Oh, another thing I do want to mention is this phone does have a front-facing camera and it has a notification light as well. Moving on to this next screen, I'll zoom you in a little bit. Again, here we have just the Google search bar, and then of course we just have my regular phone, contacts, messaging, Google Chrome, menu down here. And then moving here, I have several different folders. I have social media, TV and music, photo apps, just regular apps that I use quite often, games, clock, calculator, calendar. Up here in this very first menu, we have social media. So I have my pages manager. So this is where I answer all of my BreeAnn Barbie things. So here's where I get like my notifications. So when I dyed my hair purple and just all of the comments there. And then also my social media, I have my Ask FM. It's where you can go ahead and ask me questions. I don't get on it too often, but I do get on it, you know, every now and again just to see what's up, see what questions I have. I also have a Skype. I do not keep my Skype open for subscribers or anyone. I keep Skype open for two people, and that is for Chance and for my sister. So for any of you who want my Skype name, don't even bother looking it up because I'm just going to ignore it anyway. And then here we have color note. So here is basically where I keep all of my you know, YouTube videos and just little checklists like that. So that is everything that I keep in this folder. Moving on to TV and music, I have a couple apps in here. I have iHeartRadio, which I absolutely love iHeartRadio. I use it very, very often. Over here I have Netflix because, I mean, who can even function without Netflix nowadays, am I right? Down here we have IMDb. IMDb is where you can look up information on any movie that you want to see, or, you know, if any, like casting, for example, or future movies, things like that. I do use IMDb quite often. And then here is where I have all of my music. So music that I downloaded to my phone, I just keep on here. I don't have too much on here. I just have some AC/DC, Ellie Goulding, a lot of Guns N' Roses, Metallica, Michael Jackson, yeah, just things like that. So I don't have too many things on there, just stuff that I've really been jamming out to is what I keep on my little music folder. Moving on to photo apps. Here I just have my gallery, which is where all of my pictures are. So I have like, these are like wallpapers that I downloaded to my phone. So I have some Marilyn Monroe, I have some galaxy sharks, you know, the good stuff. I have some more pictures and, you know, things like that. So I have a picture of my Jackalberry, another cute picture of Jackal, and then I have my little baby Motley sleeping. So yeah, that's everything that I keep in my gallery. This thing right here is where you guys are probably wondering where I'm getting all my cool little icons that you are seeing. It is this one right here. It is called, let me pull it up for you guys. It is called Icoron. I think that's how you say it, but if you go to like the Play Store or anything like that, just type that in, and it is where you can pretty much go on here and download cool little icons for any of your apps. So you have Facebook, YouTube, music, your phone, Messenger, the Play Store, Twitter, so it just has a lot of really cool things, new arrivals, and you can get really cool things like that. Here we have PixArt, which is what I use most of the time. It's where you can make cool little collages where you can just pick from your gallery, and you know, you can like do cool things with them, you can edit them, you can add like little effects, you know, just things like that. You can just make it really kind of cool looking. So yeah, I do use this quite a bit. Yeah, it just kind of changes that, and you can like save it to your phone and things like that. The next photo app thing that I have is Pick, Play, and Post. I saw this on I Love You Morgan's What's on My Phone tag, and I thought it was really cool. I have used it once, but it's basically where you can pick like a couple of pictures and a video, and you can put it all in a really cool collage type thing and then upload it to Instagram. Basically, here is an example of the one that I did. It's when I got my behind the ear tattoo. You can pick a couple pictures, and then over here I have just a video. So it's really, really cool. I like it. I'm still kind of learning how to play it, so, or kind of like how to work it, but yeah, that's basically just what the gist of it is. So on Instagram, you can see these two pictures while the video starts playing. Then over here, we have another really big favorite of mine. This is called Whiteagram, and I don't know if any of you, well, yeah, probably all of you know this. When you upload a picture to Instagram, they make you crop it really, really weird. Whereas Whiteagram, you can pick a photo from your gallery, say this one for instance, and you can put this entire picture on to Instagram. So once you hit the Instagram button, you can basically upload it like this, and it's not gonna make you crop it in a weird way like Instagram does. So I really, really like that app. I find that really, really useful. Again, you can download that at the Play Store as well. So I do use these two quite often. Over here I have another little photo editing one. This is Pomelo? I think I'm saying that right. This one is fairly new, added to my little download list, so you can basically just pick pictures from your gallery, and then you can go down here and just add really cool effects to them. I don't use this too often, but I do use it, and I think it's really cool because you can, you know, just add different effects and just make the picture look really different. So I think that's super, super cute. The last photo editing app that I have in my little photo app type things is Panorama. I do not use this very often because I don't really know how to work it, but I have it in there just in case, just so I can like play around with it. But it's basically where you can just take one big long picture. So this is basically everything that I have in my photo apps. In this next folder right here, we have my apps. When you open it up, here are the apps that I use. I am covering one up with my thumb because it is my banking app. Basically, I just have the standard phone settings, the Play Store, the antivirus software, maps, InstaFollow, and Follower. So Maps is basically my GPS if I'm going anywhere. InstaFollow is to unfollow people who have unfollowed me on Instagram, and then I have the same one for Twitter. So that's basically everything I have in my little apps folder. And down here in this last folder, I just have games. I'm not really a big kind of phone game person. I'm very just simple and to the point. My favorites are Shoot Bubble and Word Search, but I also have Bowling, Music Hero, and Trivia Crack. I don't have my Trivia Crack set up where I can play with other people. I just kind of play with family. So I don't really, yeah, I don't use it too often anymore. I was into it for a while, but now it just kind of sits in my phone. And Music Hero is really cool. You can basically, it's kind of like Guitar Hero, but for your phone. So you can like pick a song from your menu, and you can just, you know, play it like Guitar Hero. So I'll use one as an example. So basically, you just go here and you can like pick any song from your little menu list. So for example, let's choose let's choose Elastic Heart by Sia. So basically it just loads up like this, and then you get your fingers ready because you're about to be a Guitar Hero master. I really do like this game. It's like super, super fun. I use it quite a bit. So you just kind of wait for the music to start, and as you can see, you have the little things coming your way, and you just kind of... text message. Woohoo! So yeah, that's basically everything on this screen right here. And then when you move over, you kind of have my sticky note side. So down here, again, I just have all my regulars. And then here I kind of have my little eco toolbar. Basically just turn this on and it kind of saves my battery life, so it'll either turn down the brightness, put my phone on vibrate, disable auto rotation, you know, just things like that. So I use that a bit when my battery is getting low and I don't have a charger with me. Here is where I keep all of my YouTube stuff. So I'm planning on doing a life update. I'm already starting my March 2015 favorites. I have one in there already. Challenge videos that I want to do. I'm doing a YouTube video on YouTuber pet peeves. And then here I have my YouTube videos. So here's basically everything, and I can go ahead and cross that one off right there. So these are all the ones that I have planned. I don't have like a timeline of when they're going up. I just kind of jot down little ideas here, and then I just have them there for me to cross off. So that's basically everything I have on this screen, and I have a Google search bar on every screen because I constantly have questions about life. So yeah, so that's one more screen left. We're back on my home screen, and that is over there. The next screen that we have, I am covering up my location because my location is on and I don't want you guys to know what city I live in exactly, so I'm just gonna cover that up. But here I just kind of have my little toolbar. I have a Google search, I have brightness, I think that's auto sync, location, Bluetooth is off, and then my Wi-Fi. Down here is where I have my weather. So for instance, right now where I live, it is 18 degrees with a high of 25 and a low of 23. I use the AccuWeather.com and it is partly sunny. And then down here I have a little kind of app thing for iHeartRadio. It's just kind of like a little widget thing. Just Los Angeles station. I have Marilyn Manson radio. I have the classic rock channel, Rock Nation, Frank Sinatra radio because my dogs really enjoy Frank Sinatra. Motley really enjoys Frank Sinatra, and Jackal really enjoys Phil Collins. So I keep those on there. And then I just have Sounds of the Oceans for my dogs because it keeps them calm. So this is everything that I have on this screen. Okay everyone, so that is everything that I have on my phone. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know if you do any of the same things that I do on my phone. I know it's like super, super organized and like very, everything is put into its own little folder, but that's just how I like to have my phone. It's super organized and it makes sense to me. I absolutely love my phone and I hope you guys enjoyed seeing what I have on it. So that's everything I have for today. If you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, share, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff, and I will see you guys very, very soon in my next video. I love you guys so, so much. Bye guys.